This is what action figures used to be back in the day, children.
Send that plane into a nosedive, Hulk Hogan.
Beat time. Beat time.
What up, YouTube? This is Big Daddy Nate. Happy to present to you my first ever pickup video blog. Some of you might know me from my other channel, Thrift Dweller, on YouTube. Our namesake, Thrift Dweller, implies that we go to the thrift store a lot. And in the past years, I've been picking up mostly video games, but I've also been picking up action figures, statues, things like that on the side. Video games have really dried up in the thrift stores recently. A lot of people, not saying Thrift Dweller caused the craze. A lot of retro video game collectors have been going to the thrift store and really drying out the market. Back in the heyday of Thrift Dweller, it was like the Wild Wild West. We were picking up everything for us, not for you guys. Like, these are somewhat of an untapped market. There are a few people in the city that do it, but it's not as crazy as the retro video game collectors are right now, so I'm just happy to kind of get in on this. I'll say it off the bat, this video is dedicated to my buddy Noah. In the future, we're going to do a couple reviews of his collection. My friend Noah is a really big Power Ranger figure collector, and he has a lot of cool stuff. And he knows a lot of stuff, too. This one here, I don't have a huge Power Ranger figure, action figure collection, but I will pick up the occasional item here and there, just because I do plan on having somewhat of a Power Ranger display in the basement. And I thought Goldar here would make a good accent piece. It really goes to show how far action figures have come. He looks like he was painted with nail polish. And he was $1.99 at the thrift store minus 30% off. So really good deal on that one. Very happy to have that. Now these I picked up specifically for my friend Noah that I mentioned earlier. These were $2.99 for both of these figures together. I'm honestly not entirely sure what series they come from. I'm also somewhat of a wrestling fan, and this one was $1.99 minus 30% off the thrift store. Can't remember exactly what line they came from, but it's the freaking Ultimate Warrior, man. Just as big as Hogan in his heyday. I loved the Ultimate Warrior. I know there's a lot of politics about him behind the scenes. My friend Christopher H will tell you all about it. DC Rider, watch BFGReviews, sucker.
Send that plane into a nosedive, Hulk Hogan.
I picked this up thinking it was one of those Marvel Select or Marvel Legend figures. It feels really cheap, to be honest with you, so I'm doubting it is a Marvel Legends figure. Not really any markings on them, but just overall cool looking, and apparently it was owned by Noah. This one was $1.99 at the thrift store. Not too shabby. I think it'll look really cool on the shelf. And now we're getting down to the maple syrup pickup of the video. Really just meaning the best stuff of the video. I will do Ric Flair first. He was with a guy towering over everybody. Not sure when this came out. Let's see on the back here. Let's see if I can show you guys real quickly. I don't know how well the camera picks that up, but it's a 1991 WCW MFD Galob. I don't know what company that is. But yeah, this Ric Flair figure is huge. He was $5.99 at the thrift store, which I was contemplating buying it at first, but I mean, it's a gigantic Ric Flair figure. One of the best wrestlers in history, if not the best. Debatable, for sure. But this came out in 1991. It's 14 inches tall. I don't know if I want to do a review on this figure, but I, you know, it's a good deal for $5.99. I looked it up when I got home with my friend Lester. And some of these figures, I'm sure it's way better condition, but people are asking like $100 for him loose without this belt. So I don't know what it's worth. I really don't care what it's worth. I'm just happy to have the figure. Ric Flair, Horseman baby. Woo! So do I have a story for you guys. About a year and a half ago, I found this really wicked bag of Power Ranger toys at the thrift store. It was $2.99 and it came with all these figures. I thought it was complete, definitely from the movie, the Ninja Megazord figures. You put these all together and they make the Ninja Megazord, basically. It's one of the things I really liked about the Power Ranger toys. They all kind of transformed into one big Megazord toy. And I loved things like that back in the day. Like they had VR Troopers. See, there's that. He turns into the feet, the frog. Now, Noah might be able to speak more on this than I do, but the first time I remember seeing these were in the movie. The Power Rangers lost their powers and they had to go get these animal spirit powers or whatever. After the movie, I remember watching on TV, they kind of incorporated it into the TV show and had a whole different origin of these Ninja Megazords. This one I thought was really cool. Kimberly, my favorite Power Ranger. It actually turns into the head, which apparently this one is the hardest part to find. Probably because it gets lost all the freaking time.
It just transforms like that. And they have these little things there. They just connect to the edge of this Power Ranger. But as you can see, Mr. Fugitive over here, it wasn't him, it was the one-armed man. The bag was missing the blue wolf arm. And for a year and a half, this is how this Power Ranger stood. I bought a new house, my wife got pregnant, had a beautiful baby girl, and Mr. Fugitive Ranger still missing his arm. Until, looking at baby toys nonetheless, like I said, I got a baby, and I find this little bag here for $1.99, and I haven't opened it yet because I was saving it for you guys. My wife is really excited about her little Ernie here, whatever that is. A year and a half later, what do I find? The Blue Ranger Wolf. That's crazy, right? Like a year later, I find it. You don't know how happy I was at the thrift store. In a bag of baby toys. Take all this junk out of the way. So literally for under $5, I was able to get a complete Ninja Megazord, which I think is really cool. Like I said, I'm a real fan for the original Power Ranger stuff, and technically this is original Power Ranger stuff. He's no Megazord, I'd love to have a Megazord to be honest, but I'm very content to have this guy. I think there's like another stage of this that goes to Ultra Megazord, Ultra Ninja Megazord, whatever. But there you have it, hopefully you enjoyed the first ever video blog pickup video for the BFG Review Thrift Store Edition. Thank you guys very much for watching. Don't forget to check out Thrift Dweller on YouTube. Links will be in the description below. So from me, overweight Nate, and from Mr. Ninja Megazord, thank you for watching. Peace.